Hello, everyone. I'm Devin Pellicone, Manager of Product Development here at Advanced Cooling Technologies. This is part three of our four-part series on data center cooling opportunities. If you haven't seen the previous two videos, please go back and take a look. We'll be building on those principles here today. Today, we're going to be talking about direct-to-chip liquid cooling and what is actually happening inside of a server or a rack in particular. So last time in our last video, we talked about the coolant distribution unit and how it distributes the fluid to the server racks or to multiple server racks, depending on which configuration you have. That coolant distribution unit consists of a pump, a reservoir, and a heat exchanger to reject that heat to the outside. What we're going to talk about today is the server and the cold plates that that coolant distribution unit services. So inside of a server, that is inside of a particular rack, you've got your individual cold plates that are mounted to CPUs, GPUs, or whatever heat generating components you may have in your particular server. And this server rack is serviced by the manifold network we talked about in our last video, where you have a hot and a cold manifold in the back of the rack, collecting the fluid from the hot components and distributing cold fluid at the entrance to the server. What's actually happening inside of the server is that we have our heat generating components mounted onto the server board, and our cold plates are on each one of those components. In the back of the rack, for some of the systems, we have a connector that's making the electrical connection when you slide this server into the rack, and we have our liquid ports. A lot of times these are quick disconnects that when you slide the server into the rack, it makes a positive connection, both electrical and fluid in the back of the rack. So it's connecting to the manifold and to the electrical power bus at the same time in the back of the rack. Inside of each server, what's happening is we have our quick disconnects for the hot liquid and the cold liquid. The fluid comes in and is typically routed to all of the chips, in a series pattern. So the fluid comes in, it goes to the first cold plate, which picks up some heat from that component, moves to the next cold plate, picks up the heat from that one, and so on, all the way around the loop until we exit back out the way that we came into this hot manifold in the back of the rack. That fluid is collected by the CDU, cooled down, and the cycle repeats. So that's how direct-to-chip liquid cooling works inside of a server application. It's very much the same for both single-phase and two-phase cooling principles. The only difference is that the fluid leaving the cold plates in a two-phase system is two-phase, a mixture of liquid and vapor, and it needs to go back and get condensed from our CDU and then pumped around again as liquid. Thank you for watching this video. Please tune in to our next video, part four, where we'll talk about immersion cooling technologies in data centers. For more information, please visit our website at 1-act.com. Thanks.